clang, clang with the trolley.
Well, they weren't quiet.
Ding, ding, ding with the bell.
They made their own noise.
Kind of like Judy Garland in the classic Hollywood Golden Age musical, Meet Me in St. Louis. Earl Short was never the same after he saw a Des Moines streetcar.
From the moment I saw him, I fell.
We did not have an automobile.
So for Earl, from toddler to teenager, it was either walk or take the trolley.
So I grew up using the streetcar as our transportation wherever we went.
Short became so fascinated with streetcars because for nearly 40 years, his father, Iman, was a city operator.
1923 to 1961.
The Des Moines streetcar system started humbly on the hoof.
1886, with a horse-drawn.
But pretty quickly, the horsepower was permanently put out to pasture.
And then in 1888, they went to electric.
Buzz, buzz, buzz with the buzzer.
At its peak, dozens of din-inducing trolleys trundled all over town on 16 separate streetcar lines, traveling to 27 different destinations.
Fingers went out to all the areas of the metro.
And the fare, according to Earl, was just 5 cents, nothing more than a nickel.
It was an experience. It really was.
Diesel-powered buses that could cozy ride up to the curb were Des Moines Public Transit's ultimate destiny. So in 1951, a streetcar named Retire made the city's final official run.
But the nostalgia of the streetcars just kept living.
Earl is a Des Moines streetcar expert, endlessly researching for the roughly 20 trolley talks he puts on per year all over town.
I work on the PowerPoints every day.
In 2017, he started raising money for the new city streetcar system monument. He also helped historians settle on the site, the old Waveland turnaround right in front of the public golf course on Des Moines' west side.
I don't want to see that destroyed. That's a valuable piece of history.
Because just like Judy Garland, Earl Short immediately settled on something to love when he hopped on a streetcar. Steve Carlin, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's News Leader.